My name is Dan Trillero, Assistant Executive Director with the Council on Compulsive Gambling of New Jersey. Young people starting today on apps or mobile devices, even video games on a PS4 or an Xbox, are finding gambling components embedded within the game. There's no age restriction now with gaming and gambling. Video games, while they have ratings that recommend a particular age for a participant to play, the ratings board will never, as of right now, place gambling warnings on the front of a game. For instance, within Counter-Strike, Global Offensive, there are several instances where one can go ahead and gamble on items called skins. Skins has no impact or no change on the game itself. It just makes the weapon look cooler. It can be a knife skin to decorate the weapon, just to make it look better. It's a self-esteem. It's a boost. It's a character boost, but it doesn't change the gameplay. However, we see many young people gambling, wagering on the flip of a coin to try to win these skins that can carry values in the hundreds, if not $1,000. We've seen instances also within video gaming where you have loot boxes, items that you can play for free in a video game. However, you can spend real money at a chance to win something of value. And this is concerning because within video gaming, again, there are no warning labels that this particular game might have elements of gambling. Early exposure to gambling has long been considered one of the risk factors in developing a gambling problem. It's on PlayStation, there's a video game called Red Dead Redemption, and within that game, there's a poker room where you can risk money, risk coins, in order to win an object. As you transition, you're now normalizing the spending of money. So adolescents and teens are seeing no problem gambling within video games. Therefore, when they progress to age 21, heading to the casino, they're able to now find different types of gambling machines. Kids today have so much access to technology, whether through their iPads, their iPhones, smart devices, mobile devices, gaming devices, smart TVs. Possibilities are endless. And so it's very simple for someone to have access 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. But with gaming and gambling, unlike other addictions, it's easy to disguise or mask. One of the areas of concern within the gaming and gambling community is the fact that one can put themselves into a corner of a room or hold themselves up in their bedroom, and parents can be just assuming the individual, the child for that matter, is maybe doing homework or reading or just playing an hour of a harmless game, when in reality, he or she could be playing for hours on end, risking money, chatting with strangers that they don't know online, and just diving into a world of fantasy, escape, and one where it's hard to come back from for some people. Even when there are age restrictions, it's just a matter of simply checking a box that the individual acknowledges they're over the age of 13, perhaps. There's very few age restrictions, and therefore the accessibility is very readily available. At 800 Gambler, our mission has always been simple. We want to provide support, treatment, and hope for the problem gambler and the loved ones of the problem gambler. We never want to lose sight of the family members who are oftentimes the ones cleaning up the mess or picking up the pieces while the problem gambler starts to repair his and her life. If you or someone you know is struggling with a gambling addiction, call 1-800-GAMBLER. We're available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, providing support, treatment, and hope. We're always just a phone call or a click away.